Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I have not been busy lately, but I finally found the time to actually continue with the tutorial series for DragonBones. And today I'm not going to create a normal animation as you do. I'm actually going to do a quick tutorial on creating a motion comic. Now, as soon as you start that project, you're going to get three options in this dialog box, which is for a phone, a pad, and also a custom menu option. Noting that a phone and a pad has their own preset screen sizes for you actually choose from. And lastly, for the custom, you can change the width and height parameters, but also remember that on the phone and a pad you do have the option to add a custom screen size. Now for the custom size I'm going to use a width of 850 and a height of 601. Additionally, you do have the option to actually change it to a landscape, and that will invert your width and height parameters. But I'm going to use a portrait for this. Immediately you present the screen with the drawing area, stating that you can drag any picture onto the stage and start your creative journey, noting that what you see is what you get. And that is actually from the DragonBones website. Also, you get this window panel here, or the panel on the side for action property, animation order, and a transformation tab. Noting it can be accessed from the window menu drop down, where you can choose the various ones and it just switches to that actual tab or panel. So that doesn't really do much in that sense. It's very, very basic layout, and that's what you get. Okay, so I'm going to drag the first image over, which is the overall page for a comic that I'm very fond of, and this is for Asterix and Obelix. Now noticing immediately the drag option is not the best, as it plops in that image as soon as you touch the right corner or left corner of your screen. So just be mindful of that, that if you zoom that far, it's going to be quite far away from your working area. Matching that up, very standard comic, very, very classic. Noting that we get on action properties, we've got the options to actually add animations to our various images. Now, obviously, the screen won't get anything, so I'm going to add some more images on top of this. Noting on this as well that the drawing order or image order is not controllable within your menu. So you're going to have to drag them in as you actually place them, or in the order that you want them. So first of all, I'm going to start with this background image, which I took a lot of time in cleaning up, and I think I've done a very good job there. Although not overly too happy with most of the items, but for this purposes, it's perfectly fine. I've removed Obelix from this area with his rock and also the text bubbles, so I can actually animate this with an motion comic. So I'm just going to add them here quickly, a lot of small items in there. Obviously Obelix, the arm, the leg, the rock, and then the body. Okay, so once that is done, we can actually continue on what I need to show you, and that is the various action properties that you can assign to images. First of all, there's an appear, action, and a disappear property. The first one for appear, we've got a few actions. We've got moving, opacity, scale, and drop, which is actually quite similar to the disappear option, which does only have move and opacity out. So it misses those last two options, which was scale and drop. So for this one, for the images of the body of the content itself, I'm going to add an action property, and this is going to be move. So just going through the list, you can see there's quite a lot to choose from, but I want to apply a move, and immediately it previews it to the right. So I've just got to take that final image and move it to the left. Now, what if you added actually action property to two items without changing the final location, like for instance the leg and the arm? So I'm going to add a move property as well, because it's got to move with the body. Hopefully that's how general stuff works. Notice that once you select it, you can't see anything, but what you see is that little red diamond or square at the bottom of the image, and that will actually open up your final screen position or your final image position, which you can just move out once you've opened up that little menu. Okay, so moving or adding move option to the rock as well, not the rock from World Wrestling Federation, but just the rock that Obelix likes to throw around. I am going to add a second action on top of that. It's noting that you can add multiple actions to a single image. In this case, I'm going to add a rotate of 3 degrees. Now there are additional options on top of this, like for instance the duration of the movement and stuff like that. You're obviously going to have to look at that in your own time and see how you want to apply it. But what I want to get to is the basics, like for instance the animation order. Animation order for the rock is first, I don't know why, but it's objects rock, move and rotate. We've got objects, the arm and the leg, but they're all in different animation orders. We want them on the same order. So what we actually can do is we can simply drag one of the items on top of each other to merge them. Additionally, what we can do is we can drag them, you're showing here, on top or below in between, and it'll create a line and place it as such. So merging them, moving that, holding it over another item, it merges into one action order, one animation order, and you can create Obelix moving with his arm, his leg, and his rock in one swift movement instead of five different sequences. Additionally, at the bottom there, as you saw, you can actually change it from there as well to play together with animation one. A very iterative process to see if you moved it correctly. So I'm going to use the eager preview button at the top there, and we can see it plays through my animation or my motion comic. A few items I still have to fix up: the text bearing, also the poofy clouds as he runs in from the screen or the scene from the right to the left, but that's minor things, so I'm not going to show all of these things. I'm just going to apply some changes here, and then I'll move over to the final scene that I've finished and just highlight what the other changes that actually can affect your design in this motion comic. Okay, so viewing the final project here, I do apologize, I'm not using a mouse, I'm actually using a touchpad, so it's very difficult at the moment to navigate through everything. Yes, this video has been recorded in two parts because I actually recorded this, I forgot to resume the recording and it messed up. I also do apologize for the audio. The audio is a bit different for me at the moment, so I'm just trying to figure out how to balance my levels as they usually were. In any case, what I want to get to is the animation order. Now what I've done here is I finalized or I finished up the project. I've got the text assigned there for Obelix, for Asterix, and for Cacophonics, funny name, in any case, I'm probably pronouncing it wrong. Just looking at the property, I've got a heartbeat as well as an opacity plane to actually bring it into the actual drawing. What we're going to notice though is when you're actually using two different action properties, an appear and an action or a disappear action property, you cannot merge image with two different properties of itself. You can however merge, for instance, the opacity of cacophonic text with any other object, same for the other one, but you can't do it with the same image name. So it's kind of a letdown on that, but I guess it's understandable. Asterix will be the same, and I guess Obelix as well, because Obelix text is in one as a move action property, which is, it's all right, you know, you get by. What we got here at the bottom here is the owl. Just noting the only difference there, it obviously moves, let me see if I can pan down there, it moves from left to right to the end of the screen as soon as it actually enters the screen, because the playback timing here has been set to when entering the screen. And then the page will be after animation 7, as you can see it's number 8 on the list there. So as soon as that owl moves to the right, it finishes its movement, and then the page bubble is going to scale in and just show the page number. So it's a nice feature, this, that when you're entering the screen, noting that it's an HTML document, so as soon as they swipe up to view through the comic, as soon as they enter that area of the screen, the bird starts moving. And you can apply it for anything, actually, really. You can say, for instance, your first two scenes will be normal, the third and fourth scene will follow, and then obviously in the forest, will start when the viewer actually moves towards that screen. So that's a very interesting concept on this motion comic tool that DragonBones has provided default on the installation for DragonBones. I believe it's from whatever 5-point version it was, and including 5.6. So here we are, the final project. Just noting, with a mouse it doesn't work so nice to actually pan through this document, but as soon as you move down and that last scene becomes in the viewer's scene, it actually starts that animation for the owl and the number of document. I'm just showing you again, just refreshed it. Obviously text pops through, and they move it towards the owl. Ugh, this navigation, it's really annoying. Any case, hope you guys learned something from this. If you did, then please like the video. If you'd like to see more on a future project like that, please subscribe. And guys, hit the subscribe notification if you want to make sure that you get notification for when I actually post a new video. I've been working more in DragonBones, doing a lot more tricky animations, and next video would be excavator arm movement, which is fully linked.